This is Tanya, News Mom. So today I'm going to be speaking to you all about how to take care of your baby during winters. So as winters approach, our body is struggling because all of the energy goes up in maintaining our body temperature. And because of this, the immunity inside our body takes a hit. But for infants, especially, you know, if your baby is less than a year old, their immunity is already underdeveloped and they also don't have the ability to self-regulate their body temperature. Hence, it's very, very important that as new moms, we take care of our baby during winter, especially if it's your baby's first winter and your baby is still, you know, around the 6 month or less than the 6 month mark. So, number one, maintaining your baby's room temperature. This is the key. If you can get this right, you've won half the game. So, it's very, very vital that you maintain a pleasant room temperature for your babies, which is around 26 to 27 degrees Celsius. Now, how do you do that? So, you can use heaters to make that room temperature pleasant for the baby. But, mind you, it is not advisable to use any heaters which have, you know, those insulated rods, those old school heaters or blowers. Or those angiti kind of things for your babies, because that can cause suffocation, it can cause a lot of skin dryness. We should opt for an oil heater or an halogen heater, because they take time to heat the room, and that is what we need. We don't want a sudden temperature change. So if you can invest in oil heater or an halogen heater, and always maintain a room temperature for your baby around 26 to 27 degrees Celsius. When you maintain this room temperature, you don't even need to make your baby wear lots and lots of layers, because when you make your baby wear extra layers, it can cause overheating, it can cause your baby to become cranky or fussy, and in fact, it can even cause rashes. And it also restricts movement. Babies are not able to move or crawl about that much, and that really irritates them. Wherever room your baby is in, try to use the heater. And if you're switching from one room to another, like I said, first switch off the heater, let the temperature be normal, and then go to another room where the temperature has been maintained. So avoid keeping any kind of doors or windows open in your house from where a strong draft of cool air usually blows, because it is these drafts of air that can actually cause your baby to catch a cold. So ensure they are all shut, but there is still ventilation in the house. Next is your clothing. So the rule of thumb for winters is dress your baby in one extra layer than what you are wearing. How you should plan it. So when you're at home, and your baby is really small, say around 0 to 3 months old, and it's peak winters, your baby should be wearing at least 2 to 3 layers on the chest, covering the chest, 1 to 2 layers on the lower part of the body, socks can be those winter socks which are a little thicker, cap and mittens. So this is a must if your baby is really, really small. If your baby is a little older, I would say 2 layers on the chest and 1 thermal you can add. 1 layer, 1 thick kind of tights or leggings or a full onesie, and socks, thicker socks, winter socks. Cap, it is not necessary, because you know, as babies grow up, they don't really like to wear caps. So only if it's extreme winters and you are wearing a cap at home, then you can make your baby wear a cap. And if not woolen caps, a cotton cap also works. Anything to cover the ears. So how do you do it? So when you're at home, you should ensure your baby's chest is covered, feet are covered. And when you're outside, your baby's ears are covered and head is covered. And if you take care of all these 4 body parts, your baby will be safe. In case you're taking your baby out in the balcony, then you must ensure he's wearing a cap. If not a woolen cap, a cotton cap for sure. And socks. Socks always on for babies, especially under 1 year of age. But if you're going out, say for a stroller walk, pram walk, and the weather might get changed, So your baby should be wearing one layer extra than what he's wearing at home. The cap should be woolen now and should be covering the baby's ears. So there are special caps which have like those U things here which cover the ears. Then also avoid going out if it is not very necessary, if the weather outside is very, very, very cold. But whenever there is good sunshine outside and the sun is out, and do take your baby out. Make him sit in the balcony or go for a stroller walk. I used to take out Noor for stroller walks in winter at 1 o'clock in the afternoon because that was the time when the sun used to come out. Buying winter clothes, ensure you don't buy any clothes which have a lot of loose fur or fiber outside, because that can come out and go in the baby's mouth, or the baby can inhale it, which can cause breathing troubles. So avoid all of those. The best thing is to go for a fleece onesie, which is made of soft cotton fabric. Let's talk about massaging and bathing. So a lot of us moms, they worry that whether we should be massaging and bathing our baby every day in winters or not, and how we should do it. So yes, it's very, very important that we do massage them and bathe them, because just like us, they feel fresh, the body circulation goes into full swing, and they just feel more active. So you can massage and bathe your baby every day. We massage, hold and bathe her every day, but you've got to take the right precautions. So what are those precautions? So first, while massaging, I use either an almond oil or a coconut oil, because these oils tend to keep your baby's body warm. You can even use mustard oil. Avoid coconut oil because coconut oil has cooling properties, and that actually cools your body. But we don't want that in winters. We want the oil to heat up the baby's body. Second, always before massaging, whichever room that you've decided to massage in, make sure you switch on the heater at least 15 to 20 minutes before massaging, and keep everything ready, the oil ready, the place ready, clothes ready, even after the bath, all those things that you need for your baby, the diaper, everything is ready. Next, if your baby is really, really small, you can massage the baby with the half clothes on. So for example, you first remove the leggings and massage the legs while the baby is still wearing a full sleeve t-shirt. Then you make the baby wear leggings or cover him with a towel, and then start massaging the upper body. We never use this approach. We used to completely remove all her clothes, because we had maintained the room temperature. Now, whenever you're massaging, please ensure no one is coming inside and going out of the room frequently, because this opening and closing of doors causes that cool air or breeze to come inside, which again can really affect the baby and might cause him to catch a cold or a cough. Also, when you're massaging your baby, ensure that the oil that you're using is a little warm. It's not absolutely cold, because at room temperature it is usually will be a little cool. And the person who's massaging the baby, his or her hands should also not be cool. So you should rub them and warm them, or warm them in front of a heater before massaging your baby. Pick a massaging time when the temperature is not very cold. So not very early in the morning and not late in the evening. Also, after massaging, don't wait for 5-10 minutes for the oil to get absorbed. No, we want to do everything very quickly. So the moment the massage is finished, snugly tie your baby with a towel or a blanket and quickly take him or her to the bathroom for a bath. Now, regarding bath, it is best that if you have an attached bathroom to a room, that you use that bathroom, because when you have switched on the heater for the massage, the whole area becomes a little heated. So try and using an attached bathroom, so that immediately after that you can go to the bathroom. Also, before bath, 5 minutes before you're entering for a bath, switch either a steamer on inside the bathroom, or just open the tap and let hot water run in it, and close the door so that the bathroom becomes full of steam and it becomes a little warm for the baby to bathe in. Now, when you're bathing, you've got to make it quick. No letting the baby play with water, or no splishing, splashing water in him. No. A quick bath, and the moment you're done with the bath, tightly again snug him with a towel or a cotton like swaddle or something, and get him out in that room again where the heater is switched on. Now regarding head wash, don't wash your baby's head every day in winters. Restrict it to one or two times a week. And whenever you're washing your baby's hair, after that you must dry your baby's hair very nicely and make sure to not take him outside immediately after a bath. So no balconies or until your baby's hair is absolutely dry. And whenever you're going out, like I said, always a cap, irrespective of whether the baby is washed, you've washed the baby's hair or not. Also, when you're bathing your baby, the water temperature should not be too hot or too warm. It should be not too hot, not too cold. Because if we use water temperature which is too warm, it can cause your baby's skin to get very, very dry. Next is to avoid any nose congestions during winters and a cold. Use these NasoClear, which is nothing but saline drops, in your baby's nostrils at least 4 to 5 times a day. You can easily use 1 to 2 drops in each nostrils. This has saline water which clears out all the mucus. So any inbuilt mucus will come out and not get accumulated, leading to a cold. Next, hydration. It's very, very important to keep our babies hydrated, like I mentioned earlier, because that actually keeps our entire body systems going. And the moment there's a little dryness in the body, it becomes a breeding ground for bacteria. So breastfeeding, formula feeding, and if your baby's weighed in 6 months, please ensure baby's having water as per their age, and try to substitute one water drink with lemon water. That will also help in boosting the baby's immunity. Now when we talk about immunity, we need to boost our baby's immunity during the winters. So we need to give them foods that help in boosting immunity. Now what are those foods? Foods rich in vitamin C, like lemon, oranges, kiwis, papaya, red peppers, guavas. Then we have vitamin A like carrot, pumpkin, sweet potato. All of these are winter vegetables. Foods rich in zinc, pumpkin seeds, cashew nuts, peanuts, chicken. So all of these four minerals and vitamin groups will help boost your baby's immunity. Apart from that, you can add ginger in your baby's diet, garlic, turmeric. You can even add a pinch of turmeric in the baby's milk. You can give a little jaggery to your baby if your baby is greater than 1 year old, because jaggery also helps in giving warmth to your baby. Then you can, like I said, must add nuts to your baby's diet every day during winters in the form of nut powder, nut paste, or even nut butters in porridges, in foods, over fruits, in any form. Also, you can give your baby lots of soups in winters, like tomato, beetroot soup, mixed vegetable soup, chicken soup. And you can also give them pomegranate juice or pomegranate in the fruit nibbler, because that is loaded with antioxidants that will help in increasing your baby's immunity. Regarding curd and bananas, if you want to give curd to your baby, ensure you're giving it at room temperature and in the afternoons. It is absolutely safe. Your baby will not catch a cold or a cough. And even banana can be given safely, even in the evening time. You just avoid banana and curd if your baby has a cold and cough. Please note, banana and curd, they don't cause cold and cough. However, they should not be given when someone has cold and cough, because they increase the mucus. Next is about moisturization. So we all face this problem of dry skin with our baby, especially in winter. So how do we cope with it? Number one, a daily oil massage helps. Olive oil, almond oil, mustard oil, or even any baby oil that's available in the market helps. Second, don't bathe your baby with very, very warm water, because extremely warm water strips off all the moisture from the baby's body. Third, after a bath, you can either apply an oil to moisturize your baby's skin. I used to use olive oil or almond oil. Or if you don't want to use oils, if you find it too sticky or whatever, you can use an extremely moisturizing lotion. Thirdly, for your baby's face, so I would not recommend you using any creams. I would recommend using almond oil. So if you use almond oil on your baby's face, you will not face the problem of dry cheeks, which usually babies have. So no creams, stick to oils. That's the best option. That's what I did. Olive oil on the body and almond oil on the face. Sometimes babies also have cracked lips. So either you can apply almond oil on this, or a little ghee because they have natural healing properties. They're rich in vitamin E. What about rashes? So what happens is that if the baby is very small and we're dressing them up in layers, there's a chance that the baby is getting overheated and you can see some rashes on the baby's back, especially if your baby is less than 6 months old. This is very, very common. So if you see this, try and remove one layer out or ensure that the first layer the baby is wearing is made of cotton and not something synthetic or fleece. And that really works. You can also apply a little pseudo creme on the rash and that makes it okay. Regarding diaper rashes, so in winters, we avoid diaper free times because there's a chance that babies can catch a cold because if they remain wet for a longer time. So it's okay to keep your babies in diapers all day long in peak winters. But you've got to take precautions like changing the diaper after every 2 hours, I would say. And immediately if the baby is pooping, always applying a layer of coconut oil or diaper rash cream like pseudocreme every time you change the diaper. And your baby's bum will be absolutely rash free. Lastly, I'm going to be talking about sleeping. What things to keep in mind when the baby is sleeping. So, do not keep the room heater or blower on the entire night when the baby is sleeping. No, that can cause suffocation and too much overheating. Switch it on an hour or two before the baby is sleeping and switch it off in another hour or two. Don't let it go on the entire night. Next, you can dress your baby. Don't make your baby wear very, very warm things at night, because like I said, when we sleep, it causes our body temperature to rise and that can cause overheating, which is even fatal. So don't do that. Max you can do is make your baby wear like a quilted onesie or a very, very thin thermal, and make your baby wear a sleeping bag over it. If not a sleeping bag, a sleepy you can do, or you can even swaddle your baby, because babies tend to throw away all the blankets from them. But if your baby is very, very small, I would recommend swaddling the baby, because that also keeps the baby warm. I used to make Noor wear cotton socks at night, not winter thick socks, but yeah, I used to make her wear a cotton onesie, cotton socks, a sleeping bag, and then I used to cover her with a lightweight but warm blanket. So it was a fleece blanket, very, very lightweight. Don't use very, very thick and heavy blankets for your babies, because they can suffocate them also and can cause overheating. So if you maintain a good room temperature, you will not have this problem. And every time you're waking up in the middle of the night for a feed or for a diaper change, please immediately switch on the heater and let the room become warm again. So the things I would recommend for night is either your cotton onesies with couple of layers, or thin layered thermals and cotton socks. If your baby is very, very small and it's very cold, then a cotton cap could do. Otherwise, usually cotton caps tend to cover the baby's eyes, which wake them up and make them uncomfortable. So avoid caps and use a sleeping bag. Sleeping bags are great. Noor is 14 months now and I'm still using a sleeping bag, because even if she throws away all the blankets, it keeps her warm. And over the sleeping bag, you can put one or two lightweight blankets. And another thing you can do at night is use this Vicks baby rub on your baby, baby's chest, baby's back, and the soles of the baby's feet, because this really warms them up and clears their airways. And if there's any congestion, that also goes away and does not get converted into a bad cold or a cough. So this is only for babies greater than 3 months of age. So on the chest, on the back, on the soles of their feet. And what I used to do was, I also used to rub a little on Noor's sleeping bag or clothes on top, so that she could inhale it throughout the night, or even a little on the pillow. That also really works. All these were my tips to take care of your baby during winters. Hope my video was helpful. Keep writing. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.